Hello everyone! In this video I show you how to assemble the Canon 24-105mm lens. Recently I had a Canon 24-105 f/4L IS USM lens which had problems with the aperture. The aperture wasn't working at certain zoom ranges and the camera gave errors at smaller aperture settings. The problem was caused by a broken aperture flex cable. So I disassembled the camera, I replaced the aperture flex cable with a new one, and in this video I show you how to assemble the camera. Actually, this video is a part of a video series. In the first video I show you how to disassemble the lens, in the second one I show you how to replace the aperture flex cable with a new one, and this is the last video, how to assemble the lens. You can find the links here or down in the description below. Before I would start, let me talk about the tools that I will use to assemble the lens. I will use four kinds of screwdrivers: a PH301, a PH201, a T1 Torx, and a flathead screwdriver. Also, I will use metal tweezers, pliers with teeth, a flashlight, an air pump, and lens grease and a small brush. If you're interested in buying them, then the links are in the description below. If you find this video useful, informative and adds value to you, then like this video, subscribe to my channel and consider donating. Links are in the description below. If you have anything to add to this video, then share it in the comment section. So let's get started. Let's start with assembling the aperture unit. Always check the surface of the lens element to make sure it is completely clean. The next step is to install the small metal part, which bends the aperture cable. There are signs where the aperture cable should be bent. Bend the aperture cable inwards, then remove the sticker and put back the small metal part which bends the cable. Remove the sticker from the cable and stick it to the inner wall of the aperture lens unit. This is how the cable will move in the lens when zooming. Next, put back the front lens element to the aperture unit. Also, don't forget to check the lens element to make sure it is completely clean. The next step is to put back the eccentric pins. To rotate the pins to their original position, I will use a T1 Torx screwdriver. However, you can use a very small hex key also. The pins should be in the same position as they were when the lens was disassembled in order to be calibrated. If the lens needs to be calibrated, there's a link in the description below to do that. Put back the three screws to the front of the aperture unit. Tighten them just slightly. If you tighten them too much, then the lens can be misaligned and the image will be distorted. put back the image stabilization unit. The two cables should be next to each other. Put back the metal pads to their place. Those two cutouts of the lens element should be at those two cables. The next step is to put back the aperture unit into the metal tube. First, put back the three metal parts to their place. They fall from their place easily, so what I do is to apply some grease on them, and they won't fall from the wall of the tube that easily. Those cables should be at those parts of the metal tube. This plastic pin should be slid into this hole. When you slide in the aperture unit, check the other side of the metal tube if the cables are not stuck. Put back the metal ring to the front of the lens. Then put back all the plastic pins. Turn the black plastic pins on the rear of the lens to their original position with the flathead screwdriver. Put back all the screws. Put back the screw into the metal part, which leads the aperture flex cable. Now comes the most difficult part of the lens assembly. First install the focusing lens element into the front lens barrel, then connect the focusing lens element with the inner metal lens tube. Also make sure that the lens elements are completely clean. This part of the focusing lens element should come out of this hole. Hold the focusing lens element by this part. The pins of the focusing lens element should slide into those holes. Hold the lens downwards, so the two can be connected easier. When the two are connected, turn the inner lens tube. That part of the focusing lens element should be on the other side where the cables are. Now put back the three screws which are holding the two lens barrel together. In the next step, the ultrasonic motor will be installed. This metal part of the motor should slide into that part of the focusing lens element. Insert the two lens tubes into each other. Make sure that the flex cables are in their place. First, put back one of the screws which is holding the USM motor. Then check if the focusing lens element is connected properly to the USM motor. You can do that by, while turning the focusing ring back and forth, check if the second lens element is turning with it. If it does, then the two connected properly. Now put back the remaining three screws. Then continue the assembly with the plastic lens barrel part. Turn the focusing ring to infinity and in the focusing window line the line with the infinity sign. Put back the three screws. The next step is to put back the zooming ring. Connect the zooming ring with the inner lens tube by this metal part. Put back the zooming brush, the metal cover and the rubber of the zoom ring. Remove the sticker from the aperture cable, stick it to the lens, then put its screw back. Put back the PCB to its place. Connect the flex cables. Put back the rear lens barrel ring. Continue with installing the metal lens bayonet. First, put back the rubber gasket, then the metal bayonet. Those holes should be at the lens electric connector. Put back the four screws into the lens bayonet. Then put back the two smaller screws into the lens electric connector. Then finally put back the plastic rear lens cover. Now we have finished assembling the lens. The next step is to check the aperture at different zoom ranges. Thank you very much for watching my videos. If you find it useful, informative and adds value to you, then please share it, like it, subscribe to my channel and consider donating. Links are in the description below. If you have anything to add to this video, please share it in the comment section.